Do they know who the chaps were? I asked.
A man and a woman. Here are the pictures. Someone saw them in this part of London. How they got away with it in broad daylight takes some explaining. One thing, you'd know him again.
He put the pictures on my desk. Hers wasn't very flattering, but I'd have recognized his anywhere. That tall, dark fellow, with the big shoulders and long chin. I suppose she thought someone had hit her trail, so when she came, parked the jewel as calmly as you please, in case questions were asked, and then he popped along to warn her the coast was clear. It was all very prettily done.
Did they get them? Someone asked.
Field shook his head. I did hear the emerald was seen round the neck of a lady in Central Europe sometime afterwards. But that might be just gossip. Anyhow, Sir Joseph died of apoplexy within the month, so it wouldn't have been much use to him.
We all felt a bit delicate about putting the final question. Finally, the barmaid, braver than the rest of us, or perhaps just more curious, asked,
"And what happened when the story came out?"
Field looked at her disapprovingly.
"When you're as old as I am," he told her, "you'll understand there's times when it's positively unhealthy to know more than your superiors. Gives them a wrong impression. And an ambitious man, and I was ambitious in those days, doesn't make mistakes like that. But it's an odd thing," he wound up, pushing his tankard across the counter, "and I dare say these newfangled psychologists would find some indecent reason for it. But since that time, I've never really been partial to a tortoise."
You have been listening to Death in Fancy Dress and Other Stories. It was written by Anthony Gilbert, read by James Byng. This has been a Soundings Audiobooks presentation. If you have enjoyed this production, please call us on 0116 236 4325 or visit our website www.ulverscroft.com.